Hello everyone, welcome to my blog, Global Remittance Market News. I'm Najmul Hasan. I'm presenting my blog site, how I have laid out, how I have making the strategy, and what is my future plan for this blog. Let's see what is blog. Blog is actually a regularly updated web page or a website done by single person, or it can be a group of people. So this is a blog. This is all, I mean, in general definition. Let's see how I going to present my blog site today. My aim and objective, what I wanted to get in future, market background, my website is structured, and justification why I have structured such a way, then primary activities and marketing mix in which is a 4P, and search engine optimization strategy and pay-per-click strategy. And later on, I have analyzed all the data from my website by using Google Analytics, Facebook Insight, and LinkedIn Insight, and the future development. Let's see who is my visitors. My visitors for this blog is any remittance business professional, or somebody works in a forex trade, or somebody works in a bank, or any finance company. So who is associated with the finance, they are more likely to visit my site. My aim and objective for this blog, because let me tell you my background. I work for a remittance business company for last 3 years. So my aim to engage this professional through my blog and make myself as a remittance business consultant in future. Let's see why I have chosen this. This industry is quite big. As of World Bank report in 2009, this company was 435 billion over 6 years time, is which is estimated. By end of 2015, this company is going to hit $685 billion. This slide is talk about, you know, high income countries. Is France is receiving at $21.6 billion. In terms of mid income countries, India is in the highest position. They are receiving $71 billion. In low income countries like Bangladesh, they are receiving $15.2 billion, which report from World Bank. Then let's see how I have structured my site. On the top corner, you see the home page. All those news, everything will be posting here. Then the second section is money transfer regulation. Any money transfer rules and regulation for a particular country or for a particular continent, a visitor will get it in here. Then the exchange rate. I have put two subheadings here. One is exchange rate for the top countries, I mean those countries who is receiving most of the forex, then their exchange rate will be there. Also the sending charge for those countries as well, how much money when they send the to different countries. I'm expecting highest visitors in this space, because all the competitors wanted to see each other exchange rate from this section. Then the useful links, I have kept all the money transfer companies, company like World Bank, company like IMF, company like US Central Bank, Central Bank of England, European Central Bank. So those contact, web address will be here, and contact us. How my visitor can contact with me via email or via phone calls, or they can send me letters as well. In the search button, they can search any of the titles which they have missed it previously. They need to they can find out from here. Then the following section is Twitter, Facebook, Google Plus, LinkedIn, all those social icon. Visitor can click in here and they can go to each specific page. At the moment, I'm using Facebook and LinkedIn, but in future, I will be using all others as your. Then the following one is Facebook page. I have a link to my Facebook page into the site where visitors can see their friends or their any family member or any mutual friend has liked this page. They can see it from here. Then the justification why I have choose this layout, I mean such a way, because it's a remittance business. All my audience are professional. They wanted to see which is relevant to them, which is exchange rate, relevant news, useful links, and also it's a niche market. This remittance, there are not many journal books or website available for this topic. My target is accumulate all those news from different source, and I will put into my site. Also, I'll put my own comments as well. Then the primary activities and content media. What sort of primary activities I have taken in order to do this blog? First of all, I have created Google Alert by using Google keyword and key phrase, which given me lots of news. I am just refining which is most relevant to the industry, and I am writing from those news and put into my site. Then LinkedIn, I am creating a link into my post. Also, I have created a group. I am creating that link into LinkedIn, same like Facebook. So on the LinkedIn page, I am already putting the most relevant topics to engage my professional audience, and also they can lend it to my site, because all, I mean, LinkedIn, I just use sharing the link. Also in Facebook, likes and interest, what sort of likes and interest, I mean, my target audience is having, so I will be putting all those relevant news. Also, I'm doing it at the moment. Timely post for Facebook and LinkedIn, because these are the professional. I'm not putting any type of post in the midnight at night. So also I'm not putting on the Monday morning, because that's the busiest time. They are not, I mean, that's the busiest day for any professional who is going to the office and try to sort out the weekend, all the emails, everything. So try to do my post in LinkedIn and Facebook, probably, you know, after their work time, in the afternoon time is the best time, because that's the time they start socializing. Also through YouTube channel, I haven't started yet, but hopefully I will be start in few weeks time. I will start updating my through my video channel. Also email, I have already emailed to my targeted audience by using data from Financial Conducting Authority. And also I am doing at the moment the Google Analytics in order to check my performance on a day-to-day basis. So I will talk about a lot more in when I will discuss the Google Analytics space. Let's see some theories. I'm using 4 P's when I did this website: product, price, place, promotion. Product, which is a news product, also exchange rate, and it is in my site. Also, I'm using other media, social media, and price, because I cannot measure the monetary value of it. But as I said, my aim is to become a remittance business consultant in future, which will help me to achieve that. And also in promotion, I am using at the moment Facebook, LinkedIn, and YouTube channel in order to promote my site. What sort of search engine optimization strategy I have taken in order to optimize my site into higher rank? I have created all the text in images, PDF, also in graph, in order to Google can find that. Also in the search engine, I have done what sort of things Google like, what sort of things Google doesn't like, well, like Google algorithm. Also inbound links from credible website, site like FCA website or BBC website, meta tag, using meta description, meta title. When anyone was searching to a Google bar, I just relevant put all the relevant keyword and key phrase into the meta description in order to optimize my site higher. Also try to avoid duplicate content when I have write down my content. Also selected most relevant keyword and key phrase in the content, by using Google keyword tools. Registered with higher rank site from the Financial Times website, I have registered there. So in order to optimize my site bit higher up. Link with social media site like LinkedIn, Facebook, already have done it. Use video and graphs to increase page view duration, because now this just visitor wanted to see videos and graphs, which will help me to increase my page view in each page, because until they need to understand that graph, so they will use more time on graphs. Continue with the strategy. Also in search engine optimization strategy, I will be analyzing my computer at the moment. I am doing it as well. So like visitors, what sort of visitors my competitor is doing, also what sort of target group they are targeted on. Also Facebook content, page content, engagement, positioning, what sort of page, what sort of content they are putting into their site. I have to I am analyzing them. Next slide, I am going to show you how I am doing it. And content schedule, I try to upload my post around 12, because basically all the professional people will be looking at the moment. I'm using just UK time, because most of my visitor is from UK. Also, I'm based in UK, therefore, you know, so many colleagues is watching that. So I'm using around 12, because don't using around 9, because I don't get all the information by 9, and also exchange rate, everything normally change after 11. So putting all those news around 12, so my target audience will have an idea what time they will get the information, and I'm trying to maintain that. These are the free site. I am using it first on Google keyword tools, and which helped me to identify the keyword, key phrase, the popular popularity of them. Also using Alexa tools, Digital Point, which I am not using much, but when I try to analyzing my competitor, I am using the following website, which is all are free. How I have implemented my search engine optimization. I have agreed a goal within a definitely within a time frame, then keyword research by using Google keyword tools, then agreed from my search what sort of keyword I will put it, then implement into my site. Then once I put implement, then I am using all article marketing, social media in order to make it popular. Sorry, then monitor the ranking by using Google Analytics, which I will talk about later. Also monitor the site, and again consult with the work with a new target group. That's the way I am doing it at the moment, my search engine optimization implementation. In future, I will do when I will have a sponsor, to be honest. That time I will do Google AdWords and Google AdSense. When I will do the Google AdWords, I will try to select the popular keywords, negative keywords, also key phrase. Also I will be doing multiple campaign group, multiple ad group, and multiple ads in order to identify which ad is giving me a highest result. Also selecting the right domain. For example, I wanted to select Indian student in Sweden. I shouldn't use google.com, rather I will select Google Sweden. Also AdSense, I will be doing exactly same thing. What sort of site my target audience is going. So I will be targeted that, also country specific. As I said, Indian student in Sweden. So I'll do that way. Social media strategy. In Facebook, All I want, I mean, my strategy to increase the followers and engaging those followers by putting lots of new content, also write appropriate post into the site. Also, it has to be a timely post, because as you all know, all these are the professional side, and professional normally start socializing after 6 when they go to the home, and then they start socializing. Also relevant media, I will try to use relevant media. Sorry again for the disturbance, because I am putting this presentation from a big hall room. Then the LinkedIn. So I will create, I have created a discussion group where I am putting all the posts, also relevant posts from my side. I am linked to it. Also, I'm just putting all those interesting topic and timely topic into the site, because as I said, it's all the professional people will be there. So many companies will be there. So when I trying to select any topics for discussion, I will not to target any sort of, any specific companies to discuss. Probably I will discuss overall industry. Then as YouTube channel, as I said, which I will start in a couple of weeks time. Also, I will start using Twitter, same way as Facebook. In social media, PPC, pay-per-click, I will be doing in likes and interest, demographic location. If my target audience is based in US and UK, most I wouldn't go to Nigeria if there is only few consultant or a few professional is there. So I will go rather a demographic location way. Also try to select the cities as well, because my target audience probably based in all in central city. So I will be selecting only central position. Also age group, I will not select under 24. I can show you when I will show the Facebook inside. So anyone under 24, this is not my target group. Also add text and add titles, I will be using Google keyword tools by selecting popular keywords and key phrase. Google Analytics. Before, when I start Google Analytics, before I do any analytics, what is my goal? What I wanted to achieve from this website? As I mentioned, I wanted to be a future digital, evident market consultant. So I wanted to see how most of the people want will see my contact address, trying to contact with me. So at the moment, I have said just contact page as I'm as my goal, so I can analyze how many visitors is seeing my contact page and how many have already been contacted with me. So at the moment, I am getting quite a lot of contacts from the relevant industry. So let's also, you know, there's so many information. In terms of goal setting, it can be, you know, how many people is visiting my website, how many people has been, visitor has been signed up the newsletter. So goal setting can be done anyways. Any type of goal setting can be done. So Google Analytics is really great tool so far. I mean, in my point, one of the best tools Google has ever invented. Then email marketing and affiliate marketing. In email marketing, I will be doing what sort of, I have done one email marketing, whose conversion rate wasn't great and bounce rate was gone up, because I just put all the contacts, and I just, when I send them email, and following day my bounce rate has gone up by 80%, because my visitor didn't like that post. Then I realized it. Also, I did that on Sunday. I should do either weekdays when they are on online, not on Monday morning, not on the busy day, probably Tuesday or Wednesday daytime in the midday, because that's the time they will have less special. Also affiliate marketing, putting other companies ad into my site, also my ad into other site. I have already got some contacts, I mean some companies wants to do affiliate marketing with me. Let's talk about more details in Google Analytics. First of all, if we look at it, audience overview, this is actually data taken from my site. How many sessions I have got? 80 session, how many users are 21 user, within 20 user I have got 195 page view. How many page they are viewing, which is 2.44 minutes, which is indicating they are not on in my website for a long time, only 2.44 per session. Also average session duration is only 5 minutes 18 seconds. I need to increase that one. Also my bounce is another concern, is 66.25, so that means, you know, my visitors is coming and doesn't like this. I mean 66% of them thinks that way and they just bounce it. Also in this little graph is saying, which is actually good, new visitors I am getting almost 3 times rather than, I mean, new visit. This is blue one is returning visitor, green one is new visitor. So I'm quite happy when I'm getting more returning visitors. Also, I can see is demographic way, like, you know, what sort of countries I'm getting more hits at the moment, United Kingdom where I'm based in. Also, I'm getting some other countries. This is, you know, what sort of language my visitors is looking at. I mean, at the moment, which is first one is GB, Great Britain. Second one is in Russia. So I have to probably in future, in my future strategy, I probably use a Google Translator in order to translate my website into different page, in different language. Also, what sort of browser, sorry for this, what sort of city I'm getting more visitors from. I can see it on Google Analytics at the moment from London. Also, I'm getting other cities as well. And browser, what sort of browser they are using, Google Chrome or Internet Explorer, Mozilla Firefox. I can see it. Operating system, is my visitor is doing from only their laptop or desktop. I can find this information as well. So all the information Google can optimize. Also selecting the data, sorry again, selecting the dates in here. Also in real time right now, how many visitors I have got, I can see it as well. Because of the time limitation, I cannot explain to everything, but I'm just overviewing everything. Acquisition overview, what sort of, from which site I'm getting more traffic at the moment. Social media, I'm getting almost half of my traffic. Then direct traffic, who is directly typing to Google, which is not bad actually. Almost 25%, and then referral. I'm getting lots of referral because, as I said, it's a niche market, and my colleagues or my visitors is referring somebody else's, so I'm getting some referral as well. Also, I'm getting organic search as well. In this right hand side is the conversion. My goal was, sorry, my goal was to see my contact page. So in a day, I have added in this day, which was on November 6th. So every day I am getting 4 or 5 visitors who is seeing my contact. Also, I'm getting email from them. Some of them appreciation, some of them asking me working for them as well. So great tools, acquisition preview. Also the following one, this is the overview for, you know, how many pages, also that how many unique visitors I have got into my page, average time, which I have already discussed a bit. Then the, this is one of the most important, where is my visitor is going to exit. First, they land into my site, and after one page, where they are going, majority of them, there is some country specific as well. So I can do many things from here. I mean, just country specific or region specific. So look at it. Majority of them just going through one page, and then they're gonna go only few of them just going for the second page, third page. This will help me what sort of topics they are like, what sort of things they are not like. If I am getting so many sessions from United Kingdom and Russia, I'm not getting anything. So I will be putting some content for Russia specific as well, which helped me to improve my site more in future. Then talk about the social media inside. In the Google, I can see the percentage of page like, how many people is like in this week, last week. Also from the Google Analytics, I can see the people as well, from which country they are liking this page, what is the age specific, also the male female conversion. I can see all those things from my social media inside. Also LinkedIn inside, if you can see it, because as I say, it's for the professional education management. My previous work experience was in colleges, so at the moment I have got more contacts in education. That's why it was the highest, is 73% are education management professionals. Sorry. Okay. Then 13% financial services, and then types of job, corporate, both. They are seeing my post. Also, I can see it, how many page view is here, how many of them is watching my post from this page. Then in future development, I will try to bring more expert in my team to write down content. Also, I can in future I can organize seminar with the market, inviting market leader, or searching for a sponsor company who can sponsor me in order to achieve my goals. Also, in future I can I mean, keep a chat form when I will have staff in my office. I can do that. You can be there to help any sort of query. Also, I can set up office when I will have enough money, or when I will have get income from there, I can set up your office. Thank you very much for watching this. I hope you enjoyed it. I'm sorry for, because of background noise. And thanks again for watching. Thank you.